ওকে, অনলি ওয়ান স্টুডেন্ট, তোদের থিওরিতেও কোনো ইন্টারেস্ট নাই, প্র্যাকটিক্যালেও কোনো ইন্টারেস্ট নাই। ওকে, স্যার ক্লাস 12 সল্ট অ্যানালিসিস আই হ্যাভ অলরেডি ডান, টুডে আই উইল শো ইউ অল দ্য টেস্ট ফর ক্যাটায়ন অ্যান্ড অ্যানায়ন, অনলি দ্য কনফার্মেটরি টেস্ট ফর ক্যাটায়ন অ্যান্ড অ্যানায়ন, ঠিক আছে? দ্যাট ইজ ভেরি এসেন্সিয়াল, ঠিক আছে? অল কনফার্মেটরি টেস্ট ফর ক্যাটায়ন অ্যান্ড অ্যানায়ন ইউ মাস্ট পারফর্ম থ্রি ইম্পর্টেন্ট অ্যানায়ন, ক্লোরাইড আয়ন, সালফেট আয়ন and nitrate ion, out of the and also the bromide ion, chloride, sulfate, nitrate and bromide, out of these four anion you will got one anion in the final exam, and among cation you must study number one lead ion, number two aluminium ion, number three zinc ion, ammonium ion, calcium and barium ion and magnesium ion. These are the common anion that is given in the final board exam. Okay, the first we start from anion. For the test for anion you first prepare the OS original solution that I have already told you, this so if you have not yet submit the practical and project copy you must submit within 1 week, those who have not yet submit practical and project copy must submit within 1 week. Okay, so we take the original solution. Now what is the test for anion? Chloride ion. What is the reagent for chloride ion? The reagent for chloride ion is silver nitrate. You add silver nitrate. What do you observe? A cardi white precipitate is formed. Silver nitrate. See this. Ekta white precipitate toiri hoyeche. Cardi white precipitate. This is silver. Now if it is bromide, I can show you the bromide ion also gives a precipitate that is actually called the pale yellow precipitate, but it is very difficult to distinguish between pale yellow precipitate and white precipitate of chloride. See this. আমি একটা bromide salt নিচ্ছি, ammonium bromide salt. We make the solution with distilled water, PPR solution with distilled water. Now you add silver nitrate. You add silver nitrate. It is very difficult to distinguish. If you come to the lab, you will see this two color. This color is slight yellow color. This color perfect white color. See this. But it is very difficult to distinguish between bromide ion and chloride ion by using silver nitrate test. Okay. So best experiment to distinguish between bromide ion and silver chloride ion is by using concentrated sulfuric acid. Concentrated sulfuric acid. I show this concentrated sulfuric acid. This is the best experiment to distinguish between chloride ion and bromide ion. Say we take two dry test tube. We take two dry test tube. In the first test tube, we take one salt. We do not know what it is, chloride or bromide. In the second test tube we take another salt. In the second test tube, we take another salt. Now, in both test tube, we add concentrated sulfuric acid. What do you observe? The prothome ekta concentrated sulfuric acid add korlam. You add cautiously because a suffocating odor gas is here. Here, see this. A gas is evolved, but it is colorless gas because the gas is actually HCl. But in the second test tube, we add concentrated sulfuric acid. See this. What is the color of the gas? Dekha eta puro reddish brown vapor toiri hocche. Lab e ele khub bhalo dekhte petis. Reddish brown vapor. Prothom ta te dekh, white color gas. দ্বিতীয়টা হচ্ছে রেডিশ ব্রাউন ভেপা, পুরো রেড হয়ে যাচ্ছে একদম। টেস্ট শিপটা পুরো রেড হয়ে গেছে, ভালো করে দেখ একবার। টেস্ট শিপটা পুরো দেখ রেড হয়ে গেছে ডিউ টু ইভলিউশন অফ ব্রোমিন ভেপার। ওকে, সো বাই ইউজিং কনসেন্ট্রেটেড সালফিউরিক অ্যাসিড টেস্ট ফর সালফেট আয়ন, ইউ টেক সাম অরিজিনাল সলিউশন, টেক দ্য হোয়াইট সল্ট অ্যান্ড ডিজলভ ইন ডিস্টিল ওয়াটার ফর সালফেট আয়ন, ডিজলভ ইন ডিস্টিল ওয়াটার। নাও হোয়াট ইউ অ্যাড, হোয়াট ইজ দ্য রিয়েজেন্ট ফর সালফেট আয়ন? Anyone? Reagent for sulfate ion. This is barium chloride. The reagent for sulfate ion is barium chloride. You will observe a white precipitate of form. See, a white precipitate is formed. The white precipitate due to formation of insoluble barium sulfate. White precipitate is due to formation of insoluble barium sulfate. Okay. And this white precipitate is insoluble in all mineral acid. If you add dilute HCl or H2SO4 or nitric acid, the precipitate is not dissolved. So this is the conformity test for sulfate ion by adding barium chloride. Now one question in theory, when you add concentrated sulfuric acid to the chloride and bromide salt, the chloride salt gives hydrogen chloride gas. But bromide salt give bromine vapor, not HBr. Why? You must write this question and try to answer this. The when we add chloride concentrated sulfuric acid to chloride salt, it evolve hydrogen chloride gas. But when we add it to bromide salt, it does not evolve HBr, but evolve bromine vapor. Why? So you must answer this question. Okay. Now last anion hocche tor nitrate. Prothom amra chloride dekhalam, bromide dekhalam, ebar hocche nitrate. What is the test for nitrate? You have already know that nitrate is the best test, is the brown ring test. You first prepare an original solution. Okay, now in another test tube, you prepare freshly sulfate ferrous sulfate. Why it is freshly prepared? Because ferrous sulfate on exposure to atmosphere converted to ferric sulfate due to oxidation by air. So it must be prepared freshly. Now you prepare ferrous sulfate in a test tube. To the first original solution, you add ferrous sulfate first. To the original solution, you add ferrous sulfate. Now, in another test tube, you take concentrated sulfuric acid. In another test tube, you take concentrated sulfuric acid. Then add concentrated sulfuric acid. Add concentrated sulfuric acid slowly from the walls of the test tube in this way, from the walls of the test tube. You see, a brown ring is formed. See this? At the junction of, see, a brown ring is formed. A brown ring is formed. Brown ring is due to formation of pentamine nitrosonium iron 1 sulfate. You must remember this formula because the external examiner may ask in the viva, what is the formula of brown ring? Pentamine Fe NH3 whole 5 NO third bracket diye SO4, and here the iron exists in the plus 1 oxidation state, not plus 2. Okay, this is the brown ring. So brown ring test is the best test for nitrate. So student, I first show you the 4 anion that is common, and out of this 4 anion you must get 1 anion in the final exam: chloride, bromide, sulfate and nitrate. Okay, hello student, any question regarding this anionic part? Formula of the brown ring is Fe H2O whole 5 NO by the SO4. Penta aqua nitrosonium iron 1 sulfate. Penta aqua nitrosonium iron 1 sulfate. This is the formula of brown ring. So these are some important tests for cation. Now I will show you some important tests for cation. The first test is the lead ion. In the final exam, you must write in your answer script the systematic group analysis, but no need to do the group analysis. You can perform the direct test because your sample contain only one cation. Okay, first we perform the lead ion. What is the test for lead ion? We take some lead salt. Dekh ei dol ta khubi baje jol songe songe white hoye gelo, eta khub somossa holi to onno ekta dekhchi chesta kore mane distilled water thik distilled water noy eta. We take very small amount of sample dissolve in distilled water. Okay, that distilled water e dissolve korlam. Ebare ki add korbi? You add either potassium iodide or potassium chromate. A yellow precipitate confirm. Ami potassium iodide tai add korchi, dutoti ami iye korchi, duto sample ta ami duto parte divide korchi, kore ekta parte ami potassium chromate add korchi ar ekta parte potassium আয়োডাইড অ্যাড করছি. ওকে, একবার ওয়েট কর, আমি পটাশিয়াম আয়োডাইডটা নিয়ে আসি. Colorless salt. potassium iodide colorless salt. We add lead salt. What do you observe? See this, a yellow precipitate. See this, a deep yellow precipitate is obtained. The yellow precipitate is due to formation of lead iodide. Yellow precipitate due to formation of lead iodide. In another part, we add potassium chromate. We add potassium chromate. Here also a yellow precipitate is obtained. This yellow precipitate due to formation of lead chromate. So you prefer you add potassium iodide, because if you add potassium chromate and yellow precipitate come, it may be lead ion, may be barium ion, and barium also give yellow precipitate with chromate. But if you add potassium iodide, then only yellow precipitate will come for lead ion. Okay, so these are the both are yellow color precipitate. See this, both are yellow color precipitate. This and this is the confirmatory test for lead ion. Okay, so what is the test for lead ion? Lead ion first test could be dilute HCl, the group test. Dilute HCl dili white precipitate pore jabe. Second test could be potassium iodide. Okay,
original solution with aluminium salt. Aluminium test is very important test that is known as lead test. Lead test. We dissolve the original salt in distilled water. Original salt in distilled water 2 ppr OS. 2 ppr OS. Original salt. Now, what is the group reagent for group 3? You know, group reagent is aluminium chloride and ammonium chloride and ammonium hydroxide. A blue, a white floating precipitate is obtained. So we take some aluminium salt. Now we add ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is not. You see this, ekta blue floating precipitate, the color ta ektukhani hazy hoye geche due to formation of aluminium hydroxide. Now you dissolve this precipitate in minimum quantity of dilute HCl. You dissolve the precipitate in dilute HCl. Abar clear solution hobe, khub olpo kore add korte hobe dilute HCl jeno excess na hoye jay. You dissolve the precipitate in dilute HCl. The precipitate is dissolved in dilute HCl. Then you add blue litmus solution. The blue litmus turns red because you add dilute HCl, so solution become acidic. So blue litmus turns red. Now you again add ammonium hydroxide. What do you observe? Again, a blue floating precipitate is obtained. At the top of the test tube, you observe a blue floating precipitate is obtained. This blue floating precipitate is due to formation of again aluminum hydroxide, but since we add blue litmus, so it absorbs the aluminum hydroxide, adsorbs blue litmus at the surface, so it becomes blue color. Okay, this test is known as lake test. So this is the conformity test for aluminum ion. What is the test? First you add ammonium chloride and ammonium hydroxide. This is the group reagent. If any white precipitate is formed, you may suspect that it is aluminum. Then you dissolve the precipitate in dilute HCl and add blue litmus solution. The solution turns red. Then you again add ammonium hydroxide when a blue floating precipitate is obtained. This is known as lake test for aluminum. Okay. The next test is a group 4 zinc. Okay. By adding potassium ferrocyanide, you divide the solution in two parts. In the first part, you add potassium ferrocyanide, K4FeCN6, potassium ferrocyanide. If a bluish or yellowish white precipitate is obtained, it confirms zinc ion. Dekh bhalo kore dekh, ekta yellowish white precipitate toiri hoyeche. This yellowish white precipitate confirm the, if we add potassium ferrocyanide and a chocolate brown precipitate is formed, then it is copper ion. But after adding of potassium ferrocyanide, if a yellowish white type precipitate is formed, then it is zinc ion. This is one conformity test for zinc ion. This precipitate is due to formation of zinc ferrocyanide. Zinc ferrocyanide, this is the formula, Zn2FeCN6, Zn2FeCN6, zinc ferrocyanide. Another test for zinc ion is by adding sodium hydroxide solution. You know zinc gives a white precipitate with sodium hydroxide. And excess sodium hydroxide when added, the precipitate dissolve to give a clear solution due to formation of sodium zincate. The first we add sodium hydroxide solution, you observe, see, a gelatinous white precipitate is formed. Now this gelatinous white precipitate is dissolved when we add excess sodium hydroxide. If we add excess sodium hydroxide, the precipitate will dissolve to give a clear solution. Dekh eta aste aste dissolve korbe, ami ekta khale dekh, precipitate ta puro dissolve kore gelo, clear solution hoye geche. The clear solution due to formation of sodium zincate. So first, zinc in small quantity reacts with small quantity sodium hydroxide to form ZnOH2, a gelatinous white precipitate. And when excess NaOH is added, then zinc hydroxide reacts with NaOH to form Na2ZnO2, sodium zincate. So this is the two conformity tests for zinc ion. One is the test with potassium ferrocyanide, when a pale yellow, when a yellowish white precipitate is formed of zinc ferrocyanide, and another is the test with sodium hydroxide. So these are the two confirmatory tests for zinc ion. Hello student, understood? Hello? Any problem? Now next, the cation is barium ion. Ferrous, ferric, copper, nickel. Actually all are colored salt. Nickel is the green color, copper is the blue color, ferrous is the dirty green, ferric is the reddish brown. Normally in the final exam, the colored salt is not given. Because if one get colored salt, then he will be very lucky. Without performing the test, he can identify the cation anion. For this reason, we give only the colorless salt for the final exam. Okay. So next test is barium ion. Next test. We take small amount of barium salt, small amount of barium salt. Now dissolve in distilled water. What is the confirmatory test for barium ion? Barium ion, the best test is the flame test. But unfortunately, now I cannot show you flame test because in my table there is no gas or Bunsen burner. You must, in the final exam, you must perform the flame test. If a reddish brown, if a brick red flame is obtained, then it is calcium. If a grassy green or apple green flame is obtained, then it is barium. And if a crimson red flame is obtained, then it is strontium. So these are the three main flame tests. Barium ion, you know barium ion give yellow precipitate. Barium ion give yellow precipitate with potassium chromate. Potassium chromate yellow color. If we add this, a yellow precipitate is formed, then it is potassium chromate. দেখতে লেডেস সময় ডিপ ইয়েলো হইছিল এখানে কিন্তু ডিপ ইয়েলো না খুব হালকা একটা ইয়েলো প্রেসিপিটেট তৈরি হয় This is due to formation of barium chromate. Now, if we add ammonium oxalate, then also ammonium oxalate, what do you observe? Say here also a white precipitate is formed. So, how can you distinguish between barium and calcium? Because calcium with ammonium oxalate give calcium oxalate white precipitate, but here barium also give white precipitate because barium oxalate is also insoluble in water. So we cannot distinguish between calcium and barium ion actually by wet test. It is best for flame test. Another test, now we perform the test for calcium ion. You will observe that calcium get white precipitate with calcium with sodium oxalate, but it does not give any yellow precipitate with potassium chromate. So if yellow precipitate, if in both case, when you add sodium oxalate, a white precipitate form, you add potassium chromate, again a yellow precipitate is formed, then it is barium. But if you add sodium oxalate, a white PPT is formed, but with potassium chromate, no white, no yellow PPT, then it is calcium. Because calcium does not give yellow precipitate with potassium chromate. So now we perform the test for calcium ion. तो फॉर ग्रुप फाइव, ग्रुप फाइव द बेस्ट टेस्ट इज द फ्लेम टेस्ट बिकॉज द हॉट इज द टेस्ट फॉर ट्रांसियम आयन बाय एडिंग अमोनियम सल्फेट। अमोनियम सल्फेट एड कर ले ह्वाइट पेसिपिटेट हल ट्रांसियम एबाद अमोनियम सल्फेट बेरियम संग बेरियम सल्फेटर ह्वाइट पेसिपिटेट देवे कैल्शियम संग कैल्शियम सल्फेटर ह्वाइट पेसिपिटेट। तो हाउ यू डिस्टिंग्विश व्हेदर इट इज ट्रांसियम और बेरियम और कैल्शियम, सो बेस्ट टेस्ट इज द फ्लेम टेस्ट। इफ यू सस्पेक्ट दैट ग्रुप फाइव इज रिएजन, व्हाट इज द ग्रुप फाइव रिएजन, अमोनियम कार्बोनेट, यू टेक स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ सैम्पल सॉल्यूशन, एड अमोनियम क्लोराइड अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड स्मॉल अमाउंट देन अमोनियम कार्बोनेट। इफ एनी व्हाइट पेसिपिटेट इज फॉर्म देन इट इज ग्रुप फाइव इज प्रेजेंट, देन यू मस्ट परफॉर्म द फ्लेम टेस्ट टू आइडेंटिफाई द पार्टिकुलर कैटायन प्रेजेंट इन द सॉल्ट। नाउ यू वी टेक द कैल्शियम आयन, उई टेक ए कैल्शियम आयन कैल्शियम आयन उई फर्स्ट पीपीआर ए ओरिजिनल सॉल्यूशन उथ कैल्शियम सॉल्ट, उई फर्स्ट पीपीआर ओरिजिनल सॉल्यूशन उथ कैल्शियम सॉल्ट, ओके। नाउ यू डिवाइड इन टू टू पार्ट, टू द फर्स्ट पार्ट यू एड सोडियम ऑक्सालेट, सी ए व्हाइट पेसिपिटेट इज फॉर्म, बट टू द सेकेंड पार्ट यू एड पोटासियम क्रोमेट, सी नो पीपीटी इज फॉर्म, कोनो पेसिड होना दे क्लियर सॉल्यूशन, येलो कलर सॉल्यूशन है गाइस, पोटासियम क्रोमेट निजे येलो। सो इफ ओनली व्हाइट पेसिपिटेट इज फॉर्म उथ सोडियम ऑक्सालेट बट नो पीपीटी उथ पोटासियम क्रोमेट देन इट इज कैल्शियम, और इफ बोथ पेसिपिटेट इज फॉर्म देन इट इज बेरियम। अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट, हाउ विल यू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन कैल्शियम आयन एंड बेरियम आयन बाय वेट टेस्ट। इन केस ऑफ बेरियम इट गिव बोथ पेसिपिटेट उथ उथ अमोनियम सोडियम ऑक्सालेट एंड पोटासियम क्रोमेट, बट कैल्शियम ओनली गिव व्हाइट पीपीटी उथ सोडियम ऑक्सालेट बट नो पीपीटी उथ पोटासियम क्रोमेट, ओके। नाउ द लास्ट द टेस्ट दैट इज कॉमनली गिवेन इज द मैग्नेशियम आयन, टेस्ट फॉर मैग्नेशियम आयन, ओके। मैग्नेशियम बिलोंग्स टू ग्रुप सिक्स, व्हाट इज द ग्रुप सिक्स रिएजेंट, यू एड अमोनियम क्लोराइड अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड देन डाइसोडियम हाइड्रोजन फॉस्फेट बा अमोनियम फॉस्फेट, एनी टाइप ऑफ सॉल्युबल फॉस्फेट रिएजेंट। तो उई टेक द सॉल्ट सॉल्यूशन, उई एड अमोनियम क्लोराइड, फर्स्ट उई एड अमोनियम क्लोराइड ग्रुप रिएजेंट, उई एड स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ अमोनियम क्लोराइड, then you add ammonium hydroxide very small amount, we add ammonium hydroxide, then you add disodium hydrogen phosphate Na2HPO4 disodium hydrogen phosphate, what do you observe, bhalo kore dekh ekta upore ekta white precipitate toiri hoyeche, this white precipitate due to ammonium phosphate मैग्नेशियम फॉस्फेट मैग्नेशियम अमोनियम फॉस्फेट, दिस इज द कन्फर्मेटरी टेस्ट फॉर मैग्नेशियम, मैं यू मस्ट राइट द ग्रुप सिक्स प्रेजेंट एंड मैग्नेशियम इज कन्फर्म। सो टेस्ट फॉर मैग्नेशियम इज यू फर्स्ट एड अमोनियम क्लोराइड टू द ओरिजिनल सॉल्यूशन, यू एड अमोनियम क्लोराइड देन स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड देन यू एड Na2HPO4 डाइसोडियम हाइड्रोजन फॉस्फेट Na2HPO4, if a white precipitate is formed it confirm the test for magnesium ion, okay। So these are the common cation test, ki ki amra korlam, First source is lead ion, then aluminium, lead ion group 1, aluminium group 3, calcium, zinc ion group 4, group 4 is arecta, manganese. It is on a deck for a deck of manganese, a color to the cobus, light pink color. Calcium or barium was a group 5, magnesium group 6. Now today the last test, that is ammonium ion. Ammonium ion. What is the test for ammonium ion? You have already observed that solid sample rub with a pellet of sodium hydroxide. Solid sample rub with pellet of ammonium hydroxide, a sodium hydroxide. If a pungent smell appeared, then it may be aluminium. It may be ammonium ion. Now confirmatory test for ammonium ion is by using Nacellar reagent. See this. We take some ammonium salt. PPR original solution. PPR original solution. PPR original solution. Now, in another test tube, you PPR sodium hydroxide solution. Sodium hydroxide solution. Another test tube, you PPR sodium hydroxide solution. Okay. To the first original solution, you add sodium hydroxide solution. Then ammonia gas is evolved. Then you add Nacellar reagent. If a brown precipitate is formed, it confirms the ammonium ion. Say you add sodium hydroxide. Then you add Nacellar reagent. K2HgI4, Nacellar reagent. See this. A brown precipitate is immediately formed. See the color of the brown precipitate. A brown precipitate is formed. Brown precipitate, these two formation of iodide of Mellons base. Iodide of Mellons base. So this is the confirmatory test for ammonium ion. And if you rub the solid sample with sodium hydroxide and a pungent odor, you have already performed it class 11, then you may suspect the ammonia, then you must write or must do the Nacellar reagent test which give a brown precipitate. Okay, student. So these are the common cation and anion that is present in the salt that is given to the board exam. Okay. So cation hoche anion ami charte anion bollam, chloride, bromide, sulfate and nitrate. Out of these four anion, you must get one anion. And among cation, ammonium ion, lead ion, aluminium ion, zinc, manganese, calcium, barium and magnesium, you must get one cation. Normally strontium ion we actually do not supply because it is very difficult to perform the test for strontium ion. We only supply calcium and barium. Group 4 is zinc and manganese, group 3 is aluminium, and in rare case ferrous ion also given. You can recognize ferrous ion by dirty green color. Group 6 is magnesium, and group 0 ammonium, and group 1 lead. So you must perform their direct test. But when these are the confirmatory tests for cation, but when you write, you must write the systematic group analysis, then you write the confirmatory test for cation. Hello student, understood? Any problem? Or all of you must submit all the practical copy and project copy within 1 week. Some students have already submit, but those who have not yet submit must submit within 1 week. Okay? Okay.